Good evening, everybody. We welcome you to a loud St. Francis High School Grasscop Memorial Gymnasium. We're in the NorCal Tournament. St. Francis takes on Vacaville tonight. Thank you for joining us on KMVT. I'm Casey McGuire. Producer and director Lazarus Sarginides and everybody on the KMVT crew welcomes you to this, what should be a very good, highly contested semifinal Northern California Tournament matchup. The winner goes on to face the winner of Palo Alto and Rio Americano next Tuesday. If the Lancers should prevail in this game tonight, we will cover that game for you here on KMVT. The Lancers, the number one seed in Division II tournament this season, they have home court advantage throughout the playoffs. So no matter what, if the Lancers can pull it out tonight, they will be home. The team's just about set to get underway. Doing their cheers in the middle of the thing. They will exchange handshakes. As there you see head coach Dave Gamblin. Coach Gamblin back. He led his team to the seventh straight CCS Division II championship, defeating Palo Alto last week. You saw that game on KMVT. You take a look at Vacaville coach Judy Wettstein. Judy in her 18th season at Vacaville. Vacaville finished first with a 14-0 record in the Monticello Empire League, the Mel League, if you would. Defeated a very talented El Dorado team in the San Joaquin section semifinals to make it to the finals, where they lost to Rio Americano. But in the Northern California tournament, you have to make it to the championship game, as they did, as Palo Alto did against the Lancers, to qualify for NorCal. We're underway. Jen Williams serves. And a tip falls in. Nice play that time by number 12, Rachel Heinz, a sophomore for Vacaville, and a side out to the Bulldogs. Just underway, no score. You take a look at today's officials. Ray Mink is the referee. Umpire Doug Hong also was the umpire for the CCS game. Steve Sherman and Bill Riney, the line judges. That Corbett tip a little wide, and the first point of the semifinal game goes to Vacaville. See the Lancers senior Kelly Corbett, captain, on her way to Notre Dame next year. That serve into the net. Side out St. Francis, 1-0. Substitution early into the game, Aaron Simmons. Simmons know that. We'll go back to serve for the Lancers as she replaces Bonnie Van Eldren. Simmons, number 7. Only a junior. Only 5'4", so she does a lot of serving and is a defensive specialist for Dave Gamblin. Set to number 7 that time, Vanessa Gilliam. Blocked nicely by Corbett, and again, and that ball. Point Lancers are 1-1. Take a look at Kelly Corbett. She stands 6'1", senior middle blocker, and an outside hitter for Dave Gamblin. Simmons back to serve again. Pass that time to the back row for the Bulldogs, and another point, St. Francis up 2-1 in game number 1. St. Francis, the number 2 ranked team in the nation, according to volleyball.com. Miscommunication that time by the Bulldogs, and another point, St. Francis, 3-1. One thing you have to do if you're going to play the Lancers, Palo Alto did it nicely in their first two games of the CCS championship, is you got to limit the mistakes, and right there, Vacaville has made two quick ones. They find themselves down early, 3-1 to the Lancers. Simmons back again to serve. Nice serve that time. The pass was too long. It's hit for Corbett. And it's 4-1, St. Francis. Simmons again to serve for St. Francis. Gilliam, that one's long. That's a point for St. Francis. And Vacaville needs a quick timeout to slow things down. We have this opportunity. We'll take a look at how these two teams got here so far. Division II Northern California tournament started off. St. Francis defeated Chico easily, 3-1-0. Vacaville had a little bit of a tough time with Campolindo, the higher seed, I should say. A bit of an upset there. The everything else falling into place. Palo Alto got the number 3 seed. They had to travel to Red Bluff. While we have this opportunity, we'll take a look at the Southern California tournament. The defending Division II state champion Santa Margarita didn't even qualify this year for the SoCal Division II tournament. Centennial, the number 1 seed. They are from Bakersfield. That's probably the team St. Francis will face. You see the big upset. Number 7, St. Joseph's defeated Santa Barbara, the number 2 seed. So things looking bright for Centennial to make it to the state finals. And the Lancers hope to meet him there. Simmons again back to serve. Up 5-1. Nice tip that time. That was by number 12, Rachel Heinz. And now Heinz, after making the heads-up play, will be removed for Ashley Dominguez, and she'll go back to serve for Vacaville. 5-1, I should say, game number 1. Into the game, Colby Lyman also replaces Aaron Simmons for the Lancers. Williams to Anderson. She'll set up Corbett. A little two out in front of her, so she had to tip it over the net. Nice heads-up play by Vacaville to be aware. That pass by Williams a little too long, but Henry Anderson at the net stuffs it home. And the Lancers get the side out. Kamala Sippen was going back to serve. Dave Gamlin called her back, and now Marissa Borelli will be substituted in for Kamala and will do the serving duties for the Lancers. Borelli, a senior for the Lancers, serves. Up 5-1, game number 1. That ball called in by the line judge. It was headed out. It was called out by Ray Mink, the referee, but it was Bill Riney on the left side making the call. So a side out to Vacaville. It was right in front of head coach Dave Gamlin. He saw it clear as day, and he didn't put up much of a fight. So if he doesn't put up much of a fight, you know it's got to be a decent call. Tip didn't work for Vacaville. Anderson, nice set to Corbett for the kill, and a side out back for the Lancers. Substitution now for St. Francis. Into the game, number 18, Diane Copenhagen, and number 28, Brianna Galvin, into the game for the first time. Galvin, only a sophomore, brought up from the JV squad. Left-handed serve. That one just barely did nick the top of the net. And a side out for the Bulldogs. Back to serve is number 3. Correction, that is not number 3. That is number 7. Vanessa Gilliam, and the Lancers take advantage of another miscommunication by Vacaville. Vacaville, I mentioned, upset El Dorado to get to the finals of the Sac Joaquin section. El Dorado, usually a favorite. They were the number 2 seed in that tournament. Rio Americano was number 1 seed as that kill falls in for the Lancers and a point. Vacaville, the number 3 seed, so they knocked off number 2 to get to number 1, Rio Americano. They put up a good fight, but it was just too much. The girls from Rio Americano took it. And they now are the number 2 seed in this Northern California tournament. Geisen from the back row couldn't get it to fall. Another miscommunication by Vacaville on a 4-hit violation, and a point to the Lancers. 7-1, game number 1. Haley Anderson to serve. That one was going long, but it was played. Borelli with a nice dig. Sets up Lyman. Anderson. This time sets up Geisen. Tip didn't fall. Vacaville was aware that time. That tip falls. Side out to Vacaville. Nice heads up play by number 2, Danielle Heitzman. And a substitution for the Bulldogs. 7-1, we're in game number 1. Number 10, Jenna Fusel. That hit a little wide right, and a point for the Bulldogs, 7-2. Bulldogs. Lyman's pass to Anderson. Sets up Geisen for the tip. A little too out in front of Geisen that time, so she had to tip it over, but Vacaville was aware. Anderson this time sets Lyman. The left-handed kill is tucked out. And side out St. Francis. Mentioned St. Francis number two nationally on both vball.com and Highwire Sports polls. They have the two volleyball polls in the nation. Both polls have Assumption of Louisville, Kentucky ahead of the Lancers. Assumption defeated St. Francis in the Nike Invitational Tournament in Chicago at the beginning of the year. Sipping with the kill. Nice dig that time by Vacaville. That ball didn't quite make it over the net. A four-hit violation and a point to St. Francis, 8-2. A lot of people think St. Francis got a raw deal in Chicago when they faced Assumption. That was a best out of three game. Assumption took it 2-1. A couple of bad calls went the way of Assumption. St. Francis definitely wishes they had their opportunity now. They're playing their best volleyball of the year. 8-2, game number one. Lyman with the tip. Dug nicely by Barnum. Gilliam from the back row couldn't get it to fall. Now Lyman from the right side into the net. A violation and point Vacaville. Anderson sets Copenhagen. Nice dig that time by number four, Amber Senegal. Nice dig that time. The pass a little too far over the net and a free to St. Francis. Copenhagen will put that away. And side out St. Francis. Substitution for the Lancers, Kelly Corbett and Jen Williams check back in. Two seniors replace Copenhagen, a freshman, and Galvin, a sophomore. And Williams will go back to serve. Up 8-3, game number one. That hit just a little long and a point St. Francis. Christina Barnum got a little too much. Timeout Vacaville. They find themselves down 9-3 in game number one. We'll take a timeout ourselves. You're watching High School Sports on KMVT Channel 15. Jim Williams back to serve again for St. Francis. They're up 9-3. Take a look at some of the Lancer family. Not looking too thrilled, but believe me, they are. It's 9-3, game one. Ball blocked nicely that time by Corbett. Free ball got to nicely by Williams. Sippin just barely touched it and it went down. And the point Lancers 10-3. Williams back again to serve for St. Francis. Sets up Barnum. That'll fall. And a side out Vacaville. Bit of a miscommunication that time by the Lancers, but they recovered. Lyman's kill dug nicely by the Bulldogs and a free to the Lancers. Corbett mishit that one a little bit, but still got it to fall. And a side out St. Francis. Colby Lyman now back to serve. Oh. We'll strike that from the record. Aaron Simmons will replace Lyman to serve. Barnum from the right. A little too far. And a point St. Francis. 11-3, game number one. Simmons again to serve. Double hit violation called against Vacaville. And another point, St. Francis up now 12-3 in game number one. St. Francis defeated Chico 3-1-0. They've given up 3 points here to Vacaville. Simmons again to serve. Part of Vacaville. tip didn't quite make it over the net. Checking back into the game, Ashley Dominguez. Dug nicely by Williams. Game number one, 15-3. 1-0. We'll be back on KMVT Sports. Lancers took it easily. You see Sternberg, the head trainer, along with her two kids. The Lancers will 24 into the game for the first time. Taylor will counter with number two. And Vanessa Gilliam, number 12. Rachel Heinz. And quickly check. Nice breather. Keep the blood flow going. Tip dug nicely by Anderson. To the Bulldogs. Referee Ray Mink made the point signal to the Bulldogs, but Doug Hong, the umpire, was right there to correct them. Nice teamwork that time by the officials. Anderson sets Van Eldren again. Passed nicely that time from the back row. That was number four, Amber Sinegal. The Lancers keep it alive, but a forehand violation going to be called. And a point. The first one of game number two, as the first one of game number one did, goes to Vacaville. Ashley Dominguez back to serve for the Bulldogs. Van Eldren. Sippen's pass had a little English to it, went to the back row. Anderson to Corbett. Bit of a sloppy rally going on, but nonetheless a rally. Sippen from the left side. That tip a little too hard. And watch out for Vacaville. It's 2-0. Marissa Borelli checks in for the first time in game number two for St. Francis. Anderson. That pass a little too far for Kelly Corbett. And it's 3-0 Vacaville. And you hear the barking coming from the Vacaville faithful. There are the Bulldogs. If you didn't pick up on that, I just explained it to you. Free ball to the Lancers. Corbett to Anderson. Back to Corbett. That'll fall. And the Lancers pick up the side out at 3-0 Vacaville. Aaron Simmons now checks back into the game to serve, replacing Bonnie Van Eldren. Barnum, that ball was blocked nicely by Corbett, and a point to St. Francis. Borelli tried to get the tip. And umpire Doug Hong, a bit of a delayed call. I believe he said that number seven, Vanessa Gilliam, went under the net. Judy Wettstein, the head coach, a little stunned, but nonetheless a point to the Lancers. That's served by Simmons a little long, and then side out for Vacaville. Barnum now to serve for the Bulldogs. Anderson pass to Corbett. That's dangerous, folks. That's dangerous. Side out to the Lancers. Take a look at this one on a replay. Corbett, that could hurt somebody. All right, I'm just letting you know that. Marissa Borelli back to serve for the Lancers. Gilliam tries to respond. Dug nicely by the Lancers. Anderson sends it over. Free ball to the Bulldogs. Gilliam again. That one will fall. And a side out to Vacaville. 3-2 in favor of the Bulldogs in game number two. Geisen.
blocked and kept alive nicely that time. A good effort by number one, Christina Barnum. But the pass was just a little too far and a side out for the Lancers. Take a look at Jessica Geisen, a freshman in the Lancer system. Going to be around for 3 more years, not including this one. She, along with Colby Lyman, who's a sophomore. Diane Copenhagen, a freshman. A bright future for the Lancers. Don't forget about Brianna Galvin, only a sophomore. She's serving for St. Francis. That hit went a little high and wide. A touch. A touch call to the Lancers. Dave Gamlin looks a little chagrined. So does Heather Washington. But nonetheless, a side out to the Bulldogs. Bit of disbelief on the Lancers sideline. 3-2 Vacaville, game number two. Geisen again. That's a touch and a side out for the Lancers. Haley Anderson back to serve now for the Lancers. Trailing 3-2 in game number two. Free ball, Galvin to Anderson. She'll set Lyman, and that'll fall in there. And the Lancers tie up game number two with 3-3. Anderson to serve again. This one's short. Done nicely by Gilliam. And that will fall. Rachel Heinz didn't really jump for that one. She kind of, I don't know if it was a mishit or a misread of the play, but nonetheless it fell in and a side out to Vacaville. Number four, Amber Senegal back to serve for the Bulldogs. Anderson sets Geisen for a tip, dug nicely by Vacaville. Gilliam from the back row, blocked by Copenhagen, she then kept it alive. Lyman down the line, that's in, and a nice shot that time by Colby Lyman. Put the kill right in the corner. A side out for St. Francis. Kamala Sippen now checks in for the Lancers, replaces Marissa Borelli. Geisen to serve. Lyman gets it through the block. And a point Lancers, 5-3. Correction, now it's 4-3. Geisen service again. Blocked nicely that time. And Vanessa Gilliam puts it home. Heitzman. Kill for Heitzman. Williams to serve. Down the line. It falls in games. It took game number one, 15-3. That one touched and a side out for Vacaville. Back to serve number nine, Ashley Dominguez. Lyman, left-handed kill, puts it away. And back to side out for the Lancers. Aaron Simmons now checks in for Colby Lyman to do the serving. Simmons serves long. Played by Bulldog. Free ball to the Lancers. Williams to Anderson. She'll set Corbett. And a touch as the ball went out of bounds. And a point to St. Francis. Ball comes over the net. And Marissa Borelli didn't want to mess around with it too long. And a timeout Vacaville. Lancers going on a mini run here. They're up 8-4 in game number two. 8-4. We're in game number two. KMVT Sports. Exclusive coverage of high school volleyball. The Lancers the number two ranked team in the nation, and they're proving that right now. They're up on Vacaville 8-4 in game number two. They took game number one 15-3. Gilliam, that ball tipped in, and a side out to Vacaville. And that's the Gilliam, orally committed to Washington University. She'll be playing volleyball for the Huskies. I should say the University of Washington. I apologize for that. So next fall, look for her on the hardwood in the Pac-10 as that ball falls in, and a side out for the Lancers. Mentioned also Kelly Corbett committed to Notre Dame, and Haley Anderson also orally committed to the University of Pacific. So Haley staying pretty fairly local. Double hit violation called against Vacaville. And a point, Lancers 9-4. Borelli back to serve. Borelli, nice effort to get to that tip. The pass was a little too far for Haley Anderson, and now Dave Gamblin yelling instructions at Jessica Geisen. Jessica knew she was out of position. That serve hits the top of the net. Gilliam tried to sneak one in on the Lancers. Sneak one past Geisen, who was still getting instruction from Dave Gamblin as the ball was served. Lucky for the Lancers, it hit the top of the net. Now Brianna Galvin checks back in. And Diane Copenhagen replacing Corbett and Williams. Ball falls in, and a point Lancers 10-4. Heather Washington holding up some play signs with different numbers on them, but I've yet to see any of her players look over at her. So, you know, maybe it's just a mental thing for Coach Washington. But that kill from Geisen falls in, and a point St. Francis. 11-4, game number two. St. Francis was up 10-4 in game number one, or 10-3, I should say, in game number one, and then served out the rest of the match. They hope to do that here. Gilliam, bit of a free ball to the Lancers. Geisen, nobody's getting to that. Vacaville was in the net anyway. And a point, St. Francis. And another timeout for Vacaville. In dire straits here, down 12-4 in game number two. The Lancers back out of the timeout. Vacaville trying to stop the bleeding. Maybe a little bit too late for that. Galvin back to serve again. Left-handed serve. That one almost went out, but it was played by Barnum. Gilliam from the back row. That falls. And a side out for the Bulldogs. Checking back into the game, number 12, Rachel Heinz. Heinz only a sophomore. Stands 5'11", so a little bit of height for the Bulldogs in years to come. Copenhagen puts that down, and a side out Lancers. Anderson serve, dancing all over the place, and off the hand of Gilliam. Let's give Gilliam a rest, or she wasn't happy. Just got a little in. Tournament. Best. Ackendale keeps it alive. Didn't get over top of it. Little high. Service again, Anderson. Geisen back to serve. And she'll try to serve out game number two. And now Gilliam, Danielle Hitzman, serves right at Cypher line, and the ball just dove in a little bit towards the end, and now head coach Dave Gamblin has seen enough of Tessie Cypherline on the floor, and she'll bring Jessica Geisen back in. Yeah. Galvin to Anderson. Lyman's tip is touched by the Bulldogs. And the side out back to the Lancers as Kelly Torbett checks back in along with Jen Williams. That's been the substitution combination that Gabe Galen has liked so far tonight.
Jen Williams and Kelly Torbett both come in at the same time. Williams goes in to serve.
It worked at the beginning of game one and two when Williams led off the serving. Gilliam, huge kill for the Bulldogs. 13-7. See here on the replay, Gilliam doesn't have to jump up that high. She stands 6'2", so when she jumps, she gets way above the net. Now Ashley Dominguez to serve for the Bulldogs. That ball falls in. And an ace for Vacaville, now 13-8. Anderson sets Corbett, tries to punch it over the net. Vacaville was aware. Now Gilliam sets it through the block. Anderson to Corbett. That falls. And a side out and a big side out for St. Francis. See on the replay, Corbett, that set from Anderson was a little too high into the right. But Corbett adjusted nicely and just did tip it in. Now Colby Lyman checks out as Aaron Simmons comes in to serve. Gilliam pretty much does the same thing Corbett did on the last play. But the Lancers this time keep it alive. That kill goes a little wide. And a point, Lancers. Game point, 14-8. Jenna Fusel a little bit to the left on that kill. Simmons now to serve for game number two, as she did for game number one. Sets Fusel again. She had to set that one over the net. Corbett puts it away, and the Lancers take game number two. Got a little closer towards the end, but Dave Gamblin says no big deal. Our team can handle it, and they have proven it again. The Lancers up 2-0 in the best of five. NorCal semifinal match. We'll be back with game number three on KMVT. All set to go, game number three. The Lancers took game one 15-3 and took game number two 15-8. The confusion before we get started. Looks like number 12, Rachel Heinz, now going to serve. Ready to put the ball in play. Williams sets up Anderson. Should say passes to Anderson, who sets up Van Eldren, who couldn't get that first kill of the game in. And the first point of game number three, as it has in game one and two, goes to Vacaville. Anderson to Corbett. That'll fall on the side out St. Francis. Aaron Simmons checks into the game, replacing Van Eldren. She'll serve for the Lancers. Gilliam Borelli, nice reaction by that time by the Lancer senior. Her kill is blocked. Anderson's tip falls in, and a point St. Francis. Simmons back to serve again for the Lancers. Ball falls out as the pass was a little too far and snuck over the net, and a point for the Lancers again. Now 2-1. Aaron That kill from the right side by Kristen Barnum. In fact, Christina Barnum falls in. And a side out for the Bulldogs. Colby Lyman now checks in, replacing Aaron Simmons. Ashley Dominguez's first serve proceeds to go long. And a side out quickly back to the Lancers. Burelli to serve, 2-1 St. Francis. Anderson sets up Geisen from the left side. Picked up nicely by Dominguez. Free ball to the Lancers. Williams to Anderson to Corbett. The ball blocked. Out of the reach of Jessica Geisen and a side out for Vacaville. Jessica Geisen that time kind of got caught standing still. Wasn't quite prepared for that ball to be blocked back in her direction. Gilliam's attempt from the back row. Falls right to the Lancers and Kelly Corbett puts it home. And a side out for the Lancers, up 2-1 game number three. Corbett and Williams check out. Galvin and Copenhagen check in for St. Francis. And Galvin now back to serve. Kill attempt by Vacaville is wide and the point Lancers. Galvin again to serve. Attempted tip by Vacaville, blocked nicely by Geisen. Now Gilliam tries to sneak it by St. Francis. Anderson to Copenhagen, that falls. And a point, St. Francis up 4-1, game number three. Kill attempt by Heitzman falls in for Vacaville. And a side out for the Bulldogs. Checking back into the game, Rachel Heinz. Back to serve number 10, Jenna Fusel. Fusel also a sophomore for Vacaville. Copenhagen. That kill falls in. And a point for the Bulldogs. Good effort that time by Colby Lyman. Ball just did go a little bit to the right. And it's 4-3 now, St. Francis, in game number three. Lyman, a bit of a slip in the back row. Just like that, Vacaville has rattled off 3 points in a row and have drawn even 4-4. Geisen. Nice kill down the middle. And a side out for St. Francis. Calvin. Passes to Anderson. Lift violation called on Haley Anderson. Believed by Ray Mink. Ray needs to use that whistle that he's got. You can hear it vaguely through the noise. There you go. Anderson sets Geisen down the middle again. The ball dug as it hit the top of the net. Lyman sets Galvin in the back row. Barnum sends a free ball to the Lancers. Anderson sets up Lyman. Left-handed kill blocked by Vacaville. Copenhagen and Geisen collide, but Copenhagen gets it over the net. And a double hit violation called against Vacaville. Anderson sets Copenhagen. Now Barnum. That tip didn't quite make it. And a point St. Francis. Geisen serve. That was high from the get-go. And a side-out Vacaville. Back to serve for the Bulldogs, Danielle Heitzman. She puts it in play. Anderson sets Borelli. And Gilliam in the middle. That ball is rejected by Copenhagen. And the Lancers pick up a big side out. Checking back into the game, surprise to us all, Jen Williams and Kelly Corbett, replacing Copenhagen and Galvin. And Williams now going back to serve. One and two, 15-3. A kill by Barnum, the sub. That dreaded seat next to Coach Dave. Lyman, ball is blocked at the Lancers. Anderson to Corbett. Game. That served a little too much for the Bulldogs to handle. And a point on an ace for St. Francis. Simmons to serve, up 6-5. Sets Fusel, that ball goes a little long. And another point, St. Francis. Ray Mink puts the ball in play, and Simmons obliges. Up 7-5, game number three. Gilliam, that ball tipped. Montgomery kept it alive. Now Williams from the back row. That's Barnum from the left. That ball tipped. Williams brings it up nicely. Anderson to Corbett. The Lancers look very flustered on that play, but that's a sign of a good team. They got a little disheveled, but kept their composure. St. Francis now 3 points in a row. They're up 8-5, game three, trying to close it out. That buzzer means the ball is back in play, and Aaron Simmons back again to serve for St. Francis. Up 8-5, game number three. A moving violation, I believe. Not a moving violation. The ball hit the top of the net. Not sure what you call the moving violation. There is a volleyball term for that. I just don't know it off the top of my head. Gilliam for Vacaville. That ball hits the line. And a point for the Bulldogs. Dave Gamblin and Heather Washington both disagree, but Dave Gamblin's a little more upset with the fact that there wasn't a player there for the Lancers. Barnum again to serve. Anderson tipped to Corbett. Gilliam kept alive nicely by Montgomery. Williams from the back row. Gilliam's pass a little too far. Anderson keeps it alive. Corbett tries to put it over. That rode up the shoulder of Gilliam. And the Lancers there to block the spike. Colby Lyman and Kelly Corbett both combined. And the Lancers get a big side out, up 8-6. Borelli back to serve. That ball, too much to handle, and an ace for Borelli. Vacaville has never been to a Northern California Championship game. St. Francis looking to keep it that way. Corbett's kill falls, and the Lancers go up 10-6 in game number three. Gilliam, that one falls between Geisen and Corbett, and a side out for the Bulldogs. Corbett in the middle, that falls, and the Lancers get the side out right back. Copenhagen and Galvin check in for the Lancers. Galvin back to serve. Galvin serve, too much to handle. And as she did in the first game, Judy Wettstein not messing around with Vanessa Gilliam. Misplayed that serve and was abruptly taken out. That ball said to be blocked by the Lancers. Geisen now keeps it alive. Anderson to Copenhagen. That falls, and the Lancers doubling up now on Vacaville. 12-6, game number three. Timeout Bulldogs. St. Francis 3 points away from moving on to their Northern California Championship game. We'll be back. Some of the Lancer crowd taking advantage of this Saturday night. Coming out to watch the volleyball game. The St. Francis up 12-6, game three. Fusel from the left, couldn't get it in. Anderson to Copenhagen, that ball out. And a side out for the Bulldogs. Checking back in the game, number 12, Rachel Heinz. Pirelli to Anderson. Copenhagen, miss hit, and it still fell. Side out, St. Francis. St. Francis is good enough, but when they start to get breaks like those, you really have kind of a slim chance of winning. Kamala Sippen checks back into the game. Jessica Geisen, the Lancer freshman, will have a seat. Nice diving stop by Galvin, and the Lancers can't keep it alive. Excellent effort by Brianna Galvin that time. She went full out for that ball, kept it alive, and Vacaville promptly sent it back, and the Lancers weren't prepared. Side out for the Bulldogs. Sippen got way above the net, but it was dug nicely by Heinz. Correction, that was number four, Amber Senegal. Either way, it was a nice dig by Vacaville. Sippen, this time the tip will work. Dave Gamblin applauds the effort of his troops. And a side out for the Lancers. Kamala Sippen puts in an excellent effort, and now she'll get taken out. Usually how it works. Tessie Cipherline back into the game to serve for the Lancers. Tessie Cipherline ran to the sideline. The side out for the Bulldogs sets Lyman on the left. That ball to number two off the end. Kelly Corbett check back in. Williams serve, a good one. Ball, point St. Francis. Haley Anderson will have. Williams serve high for Corbett, but she still pushes it over the net. Lyman's kill, a little long. Side out for the Bulldogs. Ashley, Ashley Dominguez now to serve for Vacaville. Corbett. No chance for Vacaville on that kill. Good set that time by Emily Collins. Now Lindsay Harris will check in for the first time, replacing Colby Lyman. Borelli at the free ball, tried to tip it in, but Vacaville kept it alive. Dominguez sends it over. Borelli from the left side. That ball is blocked nicely by Vanessa Gilliam. And a side out for Vacaville. Stuck on 13-6, game number three. Williams pass to Collins. Back to Williams from the back row. Gilliam tips it over. Borelli sends it back. Cipherline keeps it alive. Now Williams from the back row sends it over. Good effort by Harris. A little too far and over the net. And sent back abruptly by Jenna Fusel. Point Vacaville, 13-7. Borelli to Collins. Sets back for Borelli. That tip falls in. And a side out to the Lancers. Checking into the game for St. Francis for the first time, Lisa Altick. And number 8, Tracy Kenyon. Kenyon to serve. Dominguez sends it over. Collins sets Corbett a little high. Gilliam kept alive by Williams. Harris from the back row. That will be dug and kept alive by Gilliam. Collins now tries to tip it over. The Lancers keep it alive. Altick to Collins to Corbett. Off the end of Corbett's hand, still kept alive by Vacaville. Sent over and dug nicely by Harris. Altick from the left side, falls into no man's land, and a point for the Lancers. Lisa Altick gets into the game for the first time on the first play, records a point. She gets into the box score, and the Lancers now at game, set, and match point. Bonnie Van Eldren checks back in the game, replaces Kelly Corbett. Game point for the Lancers. Kenyon to serve. Dominguez sets to Gilliam. Harris keeps it alive. Collins to Altick. The Lancers keep it alive. Harris on the back row. Gilliam tries to tip. Van Eldren's there. Collins keeps it alive to Altick. Gilliam again. Williams a pass to Collins. Now back to Williams from the back row. And that falls. And St. Francis takes game number three, 15-7, and they will advance to their eighth consecutive Division II Northern California Championship game. You take a look at the line score, not much to say. St. Francis dominating fashion. There really wasn't a close game. They were up 14-4 before they gave up those 4 points in a row to make it 15-8. So the Lancers advance in dramatic fashion? Not really, but it's very effective. The Lancer crowd out onto the floor. Now the social hour begins. Dave Gamlin takes his crew another CCS championship and another Northern California championship game. They will play the winner of Palo Alto and Rio Americano. St. Francis, the number one seed. Rio Americano, the second seed. So it'll likely be them. Doesn't really matter for us. We'll be here.
Tuesday night at Rascott Memorial, St. Francis will look to advance to the state championship. Thanks to everybody on the KMVT crew that did another excellent job. Lazarus Sarginides, as always. Robin Frank and Brent Stone, the cameras. Thanks to Steve Filios, athletic director, and everybody at St. Francis for the accommodations. Once again, St. Francis advancing to the Northern California Championship game once again for the eighth consecutive time. We'll see if they can do it on KMVT Sports.